Which one is better, D5 render, Lumion, or Twinmotion? I decided to get a single model and create the exact same scene in each of these engines. In this video, I'm gonna share with you the main things I like and dislike about each software, so if you're deciding which one you should use or thinking about switching engines, you'll be making an informed decision. I have here this 3D model that our team at Upstairs has designed. It has a little bit of everything. Like, we wanted something that was complex enough to show various aspects of the engine. So a little bit of detailed grass in the foreground, a big glass plane to show your reflections, a multitude of materials from concrete to wood and metal, a bit of trees, smaller vegetation, 3D people, I mean, you get the idea, right? And I'll use the same HDRI on every software so that we have an even closer comparison between the images at the end of the video. We'll do a sunny scene and a cloudy one with the interior slightly lit up only with emissive. This video is not sponsored, and even if it were, you know that I always give my honest input here. I'll go over what's good and what's bad beyond the basics, but more about the actual process. And if you have anything to add after you watch this video, be sure to drop it in the comments below. I could honestly spend a whole full hour here or more talking about each of the pros and cons, but I think we can narrow down the comparison to a few items, like material creation, assets, scenes, render speed, post-processing, and live sync capabilities. I'm gonna take you with me on each workflow and show you the results as we go, and at the end of the video, we'll get to see the results side by side. I gave myself around 3 hours for each image, because while the results can always get better and better, the more time you invest in the settings, assets, materials, and more, and I wanted to put the engines to the test as if I had a deadline, and creating images was part of a larger set of tasks I would have to make, just as you'll probably reuse them. So let's start with Twinmotion. One of the favorites among you guys, and the main reason, I'll have to say, I mean, is the pricing. That can change, but at the moment it's free, even for professionals. To be honest, I don't think that if you're visualizing images as part of an architectural practice or even more as an Archviz artist, that this should be the main thing you will look for when choosing an engine, but it's something to take into account for sure. Overall, the process inside Twinmotion is very straightforward, a very simple UI, not the greatest, but it works. It has an amazing objects list where you're in control over what's inside your model. And this is even more worth it because of the great live sync plugin, a Datasmith. All of the engines in this video have a live sync plugin, but Twinmotion is the only one in this list that reads your 3D model either per material or using the hierarchy built into the model, like groups. For me, it's not as big of a deal as I'm always with the 3D modeler open. And if any changes are needed, I can easily do that, but I know it can be a game changer for some specific workflows. Even so, if you want to bring later your file into Unreal Engine, which is a seamless connection. Material creation is a bit weird, to be honest. It's got all the necessary slots to add the PBR maps, but the way the UI is structured is a bit messy, at least for me. It feels like the maps are not a primary thing. You're always scrolling up and down, opening the infinite dropdowns to get to the places you want to go. Now, one thing that is good here is that the diffuse map has a finer control built in, allowing you to make any changes on the material color inside the software. This is something that D5 also has, but Lumion doesn't. Oh, and there's one bad thing here is that there's no round corner, which is, yeah, something to be considered. The native library of assets is very limited and not that high quality. The grass is nice though. Now, the trees and plants could be better. I mean, yes, you have access to Quixel library and the new fab.com, but it's not as seamless as someone in the architecture industry would want. You've got the potential to create an incredible scenery with environment scanned 3D assets, but I feel that the basics are lacking. Also, it does have a simple scatter tool, not the greatest, and it's very limited, but it exists. The gizmos is weird. I mean, it lacks shortcuts and basic work of moving and duplicating assets takes more time than you expect. It's a very clunky process, even for me that has used Twinmotion many times. Now, something worth mentioning is that it has the best preview mode, where you can have a detached rendered preview and size the window as much as needed. This is honestly so good. So creating scenes is a smooth and enjoyable process. Twinmotion has a path tracer engine, the same from Unreal Engine, which I won't get into the technical aspects here, but it's better than just ray tracing. It calculates lights in a more realistic way. The biggest downside to me is that there are no render elements. if you can believe it. So post-production in Photoshop is very limited, almost non-existent in my opinion. And here's how long each scene took to render in 4K at high quality. Very fast, even with a path tracer. And here's the final result with no post-production, straight out of Twinmotion. Overall, my comments are that Twinmotion is a light software that can run in simpler setups and produce amazing results with the path tracer in a short amount of time. But the UI, especially the settings, feels too simple and it lacks a few essential tools and features. Now on to Lumion. All the engines have a fairly simple learning curve, but I would say that Lumion has the easiest one. It's quite quick to come in, figure out the buttons and tabs, and start working. The UI is super beginner friendly, but I'll have to say that it's maybe too simple. For some things, maybe many things, I wish it was different, and I'll get to that in a second. But first, where I think Lumion does a great job is at material creation. You've got everything accessible at a glance here in the settings. It's got round corners, multiple sliders and settings available, and the best slider of all, the weathering slider, where you can add an interesting layer of dirt and grunginess to all materials, even on top of a diffuse map. Also, the foliage option here is one of a kind, like super flexible, and it works perfectly. There are a few limitations with the diffuse map, and the emissive doesn't work that well, not even something like a temperature control. Other things to consider is that there's no scatter tool, but an interesting 3D grass material, and also a decent vegetation library. Now, the two biggest downsides you might find is that there's no objects list or way to properly manage what you have placed on the file. And on that, like, you have these categories that you can't select objects or materials if you're not on the right tab here, which is really frustrating. Not to mention that the delete only functions if you have the trash icon enabled. And I mean, even after everything I've mentioned about the movement, the gizmo and object placement are better than Twinmotion still. And then the other downside, and even more so, is that the fact that scenes is on another place. There's this place here where you create the scenes and what I'm calling like the legacy effects option. So you can't really build up your scenes as you build and set up your model. It's like two different tasks. I mean, there's the build with effects mode, but it's not as fluid and it's too much of a workaround. For example, in Twinmotion, you can just click R to switch the, like, from normal to path tracer, or in D5 as well. It's just a simple shortcut to see how the environment is coming to life. And this makes it really hard to tell if your material settings are working as intended. Lumion has always been one of my favorite programs, but not being able to render beyond 4K with ray tracing is definitely a drawback. Well, not having path tracer bothers me a bit, but their ray tracing is really good. Also, apparently it doesn't run as smoothly on my setup either, since I keep getting this warning and this render time, and when I activate these channels, it just shoots up. It was harder to control the HDRIs in Lumion, but here are the final results. Sunny and cloudy. And last but not least, D5 Render. A software that has gained so much popularity over the past few years due to their crazy constant updates. Honestly, it's the software that has evolved faster than any other competitor in the market, and it looks to be a constant. There's a free version that it's quite easy to get. It is a bit more limited, but the core part of D5 is included without any watermarks or resolution limits. And one of the biggest strengths in D5 is the library, especially vegetation. So, and I mean it, so many options, high quality as well, and receiving constant updates. The scatter tool is also something that sets D5 apart so much. If you need to add areas of vegetation from trees to plants and even grass with full randomization, you can do it. It's such a powerful and complete tool. And on this topic, the objects list is also a big plus. Easy to organize your file, filter through items, group, hide stuff. It really changes how you work with your model. Not to mention that the gizmo, I feel that it's the best one among the three engines. Now, material creation is good. I mean, you've got plenty of options with the sliders and pretty much all the maps can be inserted. However, I don't particularly like the fact that we have templates and not all the sliders or settings are available in custom. Like when I wanted to add subsurface scattering to the awning fabric on top of the mask opacity, I couldn't because the templates are different for these situations. This is something that maybe all real-time engines lack a bit on, might be some limitation, but Lumion, I feel that does a little bit of a better job here. Now, creating scenes is a pleasant experience in DU5. Everything is here on the same screen and available at all times. We even got a preview, not as powerful as the one in Twinmotion though, but it's here. All the render elements you need are available, and there's a section of post-production here that is quite useful if you need it, though I always prefer to take this step onto Photoshop. There are many AI tools built into the software, and I think maybe D5 is the only one doing this right now. But from all of the tools, what I think makes a huge difference is the AI enhancer, which from what I've tested, it's a little bit more curated for architectural images and doesn't produce too many artifacts compared to what's available online, like Crea and other AI enhancers. And on that topic of new updates, they now have Path Tracer available. So from just ray tracing, which was already really good, to now even better with Path Tracer. And here's the standard render with ray tracing. Here's the Path Tracer. And here's with AI Enhancer. And this is how much it took to render these images in 4K high resolution. To be honest, I often use 6K, but since Lumion doesn't have more than 4K, I'm using 4K for all of the engines so that we can compare them up. And I think we need to consider the AI enhancer as well, separate here, because it's optional, but there's still some waiting time. And before I show you all of the images, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you like this type of content and want to see more of this in the future. So here it is, all of the images again. Remember that this is a short but complete process, however, without post-production, just raw renderings. Twinmotion, Lumion, and D5. Now, side by side. And through the compression of YouTube, you might not see it all, so I'll leave the high resolution images on my Behance in case you're interested in checking them out in detail. Link in the video description. What do you think about the results? They all look really good and might come down to personal preferences and how the workflow is inside each software, like UI, materials, render time, and the compatibility with your design workflow. Let me know your opinions down below. Now, I don't want you to feel that I skewed this comparison because I do have a course on D5 Render and Photoshop. Honestly, I think they're all great engines and you'll be well set with any of them. Quality-wise, they're all comparable, but in my opinion, at the moment, D5 has been a bit more complete in terms of tools and features to recommend to architects and architecture students. That's why I decided to create this course. Link in the video description if you want to check it out. And since you got to the end of the video, here's a finalized image with the post-production workflow I teach in the course. And you also might like this other comparison video that is a bit more technical and focuses on the stats of each engine, so click here to watch it.